Hello, and welcome to the back nine of round one of the True Bank Des Moines Challenge presented by Discraft. It's our ninth stop of the Disc Golf Pro Tour. Man, we're doing it.
We're trucking along.
We're getting there.
We're halfway.
Oh, man.
That's weird. I don't want to think about it like that.
I'm Erica Stinchcomb.
I'm Madison Walker. We're your two hot geese.
Honk.
Honk. We are back.
Yeah, back and still bad at math.
We have nine more holes, and it continues to get just hotter and hotter out here at Pickard Park. Really high UV index like we've had all week. We should be used to it by now. Look at all that green.
Yeah, Paige Pierce with a bogey-free five down through nine so far. Kristen Tatar, one flaw on hole five, but four down. Juliana Korver and Missy Gannon both two under. And the whole field is shredding it here, folks.
Yeah, this course is really fun to play because it is super scoreable, but is by no means an easy course because, like Erica said in the front nine, it keeps you honest. Lots of OB and lots of hills that you have to work around.
Hole 10 is a slightly different hole from last year. We're going from a tee pad farther back into the left. A lot of women going to go through the trees like the drone did. Second shot, you want to get up and over the hill and ideally somewhere to the side of that large tree that we passed. And the pin used to be across. You can see the MPO basket across that little dry creek. Now it is short of it. You can see the various landing zones. OB lines the way. First things first, just get through the tunnel of trees. There used to be more of a hyzer. You can see Paige forcing the hyzer a little bit, and you just have to be careful with this. You can get it a little wide and never come back in bounds, but Paige Pierce obviously knows what's up.
Yeah, not a super common play, I would say, for FPO to go that wide hyzer route. It requires, I would say, about 400 feet of hyzer ability.
Love that.
Kristen's got it, though. And they're both safe, taking the trees completely out of play.
Do you try to make a tongue twister in your head when you hear Pickard Park?
No, I don't.
Oh, you're not trying to like park a par at Pickard Park?
No, I'm not.
Oh, okay. I wanted to clarify that. Juliana going out and around as well.
Is there something there I'm missing? No one on my car did that today, but it seems like everybody be doing that.
I tried it in practice, and it's there. A lot of times the wind, if it's up, is going to push left to right on this hole, though. So I think it wasn't worth it in practice, but the wind's kind of down.
What Missy just did is a more common play, although it does bring some trees into play if you do hyzer out. But if you can get it to push straight, it's a great play. It works just fine for the birdie.
You really don't have to bite off too much distance on the tee shot either to birdie this one. All you have to do is get over the hill just enough to see the basket on the second shot. Juliana should be in a decent spot. Maybe battling that tree just a little bit. I personally like right side of the tree, but both work fine.
Yeah, so the change definitely softened up this par five a good bit. You can make a mistake and still get a birdie. It's as long as you just get over this hill on your second shot. Mm-hmm. Now, that out of bounds does come in really close to the basket, so you know you can pick up strokes in that way, but the distance doesn't lie. You can very easily save birdie from making a mistake. I mean par, sorry, for making a mistake.
Kristen really burning one early. Paige way up here. Can probably get down there for a putt depending on how aggressive she is, and that looks very aggressive.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay.
Cool.
Really?
That's great.
Yeah, really trusting that disc out over OB.
Getting nearly to circle two. This is tough. This is right where it's still blind.
Do you think she's going for it?
Yeah, I think so.
I think so, too.
Looks like a fairway driver or something in her hand, maybe a Saint Pro.
I like that very linear, straight route.
Amazing.
Wow.
Unbelievable.
Wow.
Yeah, that's such a hard shot. And I know normally we're always like, oh, cool, it's more scoreable, like, soften the par. Mm-hmm. Disc golf is hard. But I actually liked this one better before.
Me, too.
I think they just needed to widen the layup zone. I think that's what made it so difficult. But I think it was really a fair par five before. Now it's like maybe a little soft. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. I hit two trees trying to get out of the gap and still easily saved a par. So it's, if you can make that many mistakes, it needs a little work. 35% of the field taking a birdie on this one.
Missy going to be the closest to the pin, it looks like. Paige with... That's an eagle bid.
Yep.
I mean, she's, 85, 90 feet, something like that, but still.
Downhill.
This would be unbelievable.
Giving it every bit of try. Landing just outside the bullseye for her birdie.
Juliana for her birdie bid. Oh, it's the band. Look good. Kirsten with an unbelievable birdie save.
Yeah, that was such a great recovery.
Third shot was fire.
Missy and Paige making the birdie look very easy. 43% of the field getting to circle one for birdie, 54 getting to circle two. Water bottles in hand. You got to stay hydrated out here. It is the most important.
That's four in a row for Paige Pierce. I think we decided we're going to go indigo bunting.
They're all over this course and they're so pretty. Congrats on your indigo bunting, Paige Pierce.
Fantastic.
I think we'll see more of them as the rounds move on. Hole 11, 453. I kind of love this hole because the tee shot isn't just easy. You can bite off a bunch though if you're feeling super aggressive, but you can get very punished if you take a high risk here. Going right off the tee is brutal. Going left immediately removes the ability to get the birdie. You just have to throw something dead straight and land it in the middle, and then you have a little putter or mid-range approach to the basket.
Yeah, I like going mid-range. Just keep it in the center and too crazy. Split the hole in half. But you do see people, you know, get crazy through the gap and throw a distance driver and have a really easy, you know, layup. So. Yep.
Yeah, there's a low-hanging tree branch on the right that makes just a dummy hyzer to the middle not able to be your choice.
Jesus. Yes.
And so you have to throw a slight turnover.
Or a straight shot. Yes, very well said. Really pretty shot here from Missy.
Trying to say things in as many words as possible.
Like that.
Yeah. I like the low play.
And Missy and Juliana going their normal thrasher and star turn plays.
Juliana's getting very fortunate through that branch. Still covering a lot of ground.
Kristen went Orbit St. Pro, and Paige was the only one to kind of chill out. She threw a fierce, but she threw really far. She's still way up there.
Yep.
Going fierce again. Bullseye.
The grass is so much thicker this year. I feel like we're seeing less rollaways than ever. But this hole, if the grass is thin, is very prone to long rollaways.
Yeah, you really cannot come in on too much of a hyzer angle because it's going to pick up and just go bye-bye. Mm-hmm. Everyone looking really clean on their upshots. Missy in the bullseye as well.
42% of the field getting a birdie on this one, 47% getting to circle one in regulation, 75 getting to circle two.
Yeah. Our feature card just absolutely parking this hole. Juliana with the longest putt at about 13 feet makes good, looking like a star frame. Everyone better make it or else I'm going to look like a jerk.
I'll go a step further and say this looks like a donation to Edge. Two star frames already in this round.
I'm a big fan. Oh my gosh, words. I am a big fan of slow motion fist bumps.
Me too.
I decided just love like that. I could watch a compilation of that for a while, like probably an embarrassing amount of time.
That's how you get hyped before your round.
Yeah, just slowly hyped. Hole 12 is a double mandatory. It's a par 3, 260 feet. You're throwing downhill, so you really don't have to throw very hard. You can go backhand slow speed disc like a putter or a mid-range. I think it shapes up a little bit better for the sidearm. There is OB kind of deep right side that comes into play a little bit more on the forehand if you're not careful. And then another common mistake is, I wouldn't even call it a mistake, common play is throwing it low at the ground and then getting caught up on that rock wall and leaving yourself a pretty hefty putt. Paige, did she kick?
It was hard to tell. It looked like I think it went to the right.
Okay.
Can be very difficult to recover from over there. There is a little gully that is... Is it out of bounds? Is that gully
on the right? Yeah. Okay. Not all of it, but yeah. Kristen throwing a grand glory, and she's going to be putting for birdie. The drop zone that we passed in the flyover and that you can kind of see is only if you miss the mandatories. Otherwise, it's normal OB rules.
I see coming up short. Just going to be settling for par most likely here.
Juliana with an Atlas. Ooh, that's in trouble.
That looks like it may have missed the mandatory. Yeah.
And this is not a gimme bogey save. You know, we saw kind of a... Oh, Paige missed it too? Maybe I'm wrong. But I thought it was just for the missed mandatory. Paige going deep of the basket.
After any tee shot that lands out of bounds, player must proceed to the drop zone.
My bad. I know the rules. I'm a professional.
Missy with a nice little layup to the bullseye.
Yeah, it's a pretty tough little drop zone. You really have to meter your speed and try to stay close. It's really easy to do what Paige just did and kind of blow past it.
Yeah, and if you just go 15 feet past on the left side, there's some low-hanging trees where Kristen is right now that can be really difficult to putt underneath on this elevated basket.
Mm-hmm. Or is it?
29% of the field taking a birdie here, but 36 taking a bogey or worse. So this is one of those that can get away from you. It's just right there in front of you, no problem, but easy to pick up strokes.
Yes. Dang, double bogey for Paige. First blemish on the scorecard.
At Discraft, we don't wait to see what the future holds. We build it. The future is in your hands.
Hole 13 played as the second most difficult hole of the day. Even though it's only 333 feet, it is so tough to get through all these gaps and get to this heavily guarded basket. There is out of bounds on the right-hand side that comes into play if you turn something over, if you throw a sidearm that gets a big skip. But mostly what you're worried about here is just getting through these initial gaps. You can go left side like Kristen is. Love that, taking to the sky. Not a lot of players have that in their toolkit, though.
That is the shot if you have it.
Mm-hmm. I like the middle gap with something a little slower and flippier and just hope you don't turn over early. But things you want to avoid is kicking right into that corner. It is brutal in there, and all you have left is a pitch out. I like Missy's play here. It doesn't look like she was necessarily even trying to get all the way there. She was just trying to get through that gap and keep it low.
It was a thrasher, so...
Oh, God. No, she was going for it.
Yeah, I think she did turf it a little bit. Juliana turning her Roadrunner over, kicking to the left after a tree hit. And that could be tough there, or it might be okay. It's hard to say. Paige trying to go that high left forehand route a little early, but in a fine spot.
You know, if Paige is pulling out a sidearm off the tee,
that's the play.
Yeah, it's the backhand is tough.
It is. But just like you said, not a lot of women have that power high hyzer forehand. It's a difficult shot.
Yeah, look at Juliana's sidearm. Yeah, girl. Scramble from the hip. I love that.
So touchy, so perfect. Paige curving one in. It's a Crystal Fierce on an Anheuser. Goes a little bit deep. She's got maybe 25 feet coming back.
Missy throwing a sidearm approach as well. Working out just fine, just outside the bullseye.
Kristen for a long birdie look. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
This is a bonus. And this slow mez is also a bonus.
By bonus, Erica means the only birdie of the day.
Yeah, that's what it means.
Wow. And no one got to circle one in regulation. Only 13% of the field got to circle two in regulation.
Dang.
It's only six people.
Well, cool. I'm glad we got to see the only birdie. And what a great scramble from Paige. Great par save.
And that's how this hole is. At 333, you're going to have to make a tester putt, most likely for par.
Crazy.
It's so tough. I was thinking about just breaking it down into two shorter shots and mm-hmm. just trying to get to the open, pitch up, and take the par, because going for it, I feel like it's not maybe worth the risk.
Yeah, I feel you, but it's hard to concede a 333-foot hole.
It is. Oh, disc golf.
Oh, disc golf.
Kristen, big flexing on the rest of the field. She is going to be in first place by 2 strokes through 13. Emily Beach just behind her.
Hole 14. At 606 feet, you want to throw something out to the right side, a backhand that then kind of fades into the middle. A little bit to the left is kind of nice, because then it makes a hyzer over that out-of-bounds creek area. You can get a look at this one, but it's a very technical upshot. How far do you think the upshot is from your drive?
Like, from the drop zone?
From your drive.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, so that's what I meant. From the landing zone, it's probably like, I don't know, 225, 250.
250 was my guess. Oh, interesting. I haven't seen this. And the drone showed there's OB on the left side, but they actually removed the OB on the left side. I don't know if it's just for FPO or what, but you can fade left now into the tall grass and still be safe.
Yep. There is OB that starts all the way down in the gully, which doesn't come into play until your second shot.
Yeah. What happens, though, if you're in the tall stuff on the right or left is you end up laying up short of the gully and then... It's a pretty tough third shot from there. So hopefully these ladies can all get into position. So far, everyone's looking good.
This hole plays so much harder when it's windy.
Yeah.
But having calm conditions like this, birdie ability is sky high. Everyone's really wanting to put themselves into position.
Birdie ability. I just really wanted to say it after you said it.
It's a good one.
It is a good one. Ooh, pretty flip up from Paige. All of our feature card ladies in a decent position to attack.
Juliana, more from the hyzer angle.
If you make a mistake here, you want to end up on the left side. Did she make it across?
I think she did. Yeah, yeah.
If you pull it too far to the right, that's where that OB gets kind of wider and can just swallow up your disc. It's pretty rough over there.
Yeah, any tree kick on the right is not good. Kristen opting for the sidearm. That's a play that I didn't consider because I don't have that far of a sidearm, but I think I love the sidearm play here.
It makes a lot of sense.
Mm-hmm. Paige with a more straight, even a turnover type of approach, but you can see that low ceiling where they're up high on the hill. It makes it very difficult to protrude all the way to the green.
Missy, this is kind of what I was talking about, landing on the left side, and then you can throw a bit more of a hyzer. She does swing a little too far to the right, but I believe she's in bounds.
Yep. Yeah, it's rough.
I've not seen it over there. That's not great.
Juliana from the little left side corner. Not great there. I'm surprised Missy landed safe because she's landing. She's got to be right by a stake.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. It is kind of an interesting OB line because if you do go out, it's really hard to then just throw your upshot from there.
And so this low ceiling play from the other side, only 11% of the field got to circle one. This is way more common, 36% of the field getting to circle two.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you're happy just getting a look on this one typically. Ooh.
Wow. What a bid.
Page for her birdie. About 55, 60 feet or so. Let's see it.
Count it. Love the little step putt.
And she was walking that in pretty much the second it was out of her hand.
Yep, she knew it. Only 7 birdies on the day.
That'll be to pick one up on the leader. Missy with a big putt of her own.
Really nice par save.
Mm-hmm, impressive.
The scramble queen strikes again.
And Juliana scrambling for her par as well. Solid play from our feature card. Reaction cam. Kristen still leading the way, 8 down through 14. Emily Beach holding strong, 7 down. Paige in third.
Hole 15, an uphill tee shot. You want to get around this tree, but pushing straight towards that OB line on the right side or straight from the tee pad is a great place to be. We have a shorter basket this year. We used to be far to the right, all the way by that advertisement wall, but now we are short just around this corner. Definitely simplifying the hole, making it more birdieable, taking out a lot of OB shots that we would normally be seeing on our second shot. If you do go and high throughout early left, when you're trying to approach the green, it can be a little tricky back there, but they cleared that corner out a lot.
Paige just once again annihilating her drive. It was an ESP Zeus.
Yeah, she just
probably
has like
50 feet past where you typically land.
She just has like an overstable putter shot to the green.
Impressive. I do really like this change. I think this was one of the hardest holes last year, slash most boring, because no one could really get there.
Yep. The second shot was much too demanding, not enough room to work, and way too risky to go for.
Yeah. Now, though, we're going to see lots of birdie bids. Kristen throwing her tournament fortress and working over to a good spot. This is a blizzard wraith from Juliana.
Another error you want to avoid here that can get out of control quickly is early left. It is brutal down there. It drops off pretty quickly into a wooded abyss.
Yeah, there's kind of a false corner, though. If you just barely miss your second shot, there's a couple of routes to the pin. Mm-hmm. Missy hitting the one tree you really can't hit. And this is a tough shot. You're throwing with uphill footing, trying to kind of throw a forced anhyzer a little bit, get the disc to push really straight before swinging in. Is she? I'm not narrating her shot. I'm just saying what she should do, and she did it. That was amazing.
That was so good.
Big flex, Missy. Uh-huh. That's so far. I mean, that was like, that has to be
350.
Yeah, at least.
And
but
it's uphill.
With uphill, yeah, really, yeah. More uphill than it looks, mm-hmm. footing.
Juliana making that shot look very easy as well. Two great recoveries from being a little early.
Kristen in a better spot here. Swings one out wide.
Maybe it's kind of good over there because you can just hyzer to the basket instead of having to throw something that pushes straight or almost flexes. Because see, Paige?
Pushing the OB deep I don't think is a bad thing. But Paige is like way farther than you or I are ever going to land.
Yep, she is inside the circle, it looks
like.
I think
she might have gone past it, actually.
Oh, really?
Deep, yeah. Oh, maybe she's still inside. It's hard to tell because the MPO tassels might still be around there as well. Okay.
Wow.
Get a girl back-to-back slow messes?
Back-to-back circle two step putts.
Yes, please. Walks this one in right away as well.
Wow.
Love to see it.
This played as the third easiest hole of the day. Paige contributing to those stats. Kristen with a little more work to do for birdie.
That must have been even harder than it looked.
Yeah.
Juliana makes good on her birdie, and who would have thought Missy first off the tee, last a putt.
Three birdies and a par will get us through hole 15. Another slow-mo fist bump.
I wasn't going to say it, but you know I'm digging it.
Feeling really good on the back nine right now. Emily Beach holding on to her second place positioning, but Paige tying it up now after that second big stepper.
Hole 16, you do throw through a gap, but it's not that narrow. It's very doable. You want to push like an overstable putter, I think, is the ideal play, kind of straight down the hill and then begin to fade about 3/4 of the way through the flight. The OB right comes into play really fast if you throw too straight. You see a lot of people saw it off to the left and end up on that left side, but it is safe over there, so that is the mistake to make. This is strange.
Yeah, I feel like maybe that was a little bit of a grip lock. I don't think there's a good enough gap to take to the sky like that over there.
And then I should mention too, the OB does wrap all the way around the green, comes into play very fast if you get some bad skips. This looks good. It just needs to fade.
Ooh, that might have been some tree love.
Yeah.
Yep, checks her up just before the out of bounds.
Missy going ESP buzz, so stable mid-range. I think the mids tend to push a little too... Whoa, she kind of yanked that one too. Yeah. I think the mids push a little too far.
I like trying... You can see a bending tree in the middle of the fairway. I like trying to fade before that.
Yeah, same.
Kristen went way before that, kind of an early release into the corner. They're going to have some difficult up and downs.
Yeah, no one really showing us the way today.
This is super downhill on a very fast green.
And, like, really pinched. Mm-hmm. Usually Kristen is really good at those Anheuser, like, soft turning Anheuser forehands, but it was not a lot of room to work with there.
No, and super risky shot as well. She was probably trying not to go out of bounds.
Paige actually not in a bad spot after kind of a grip lock drive. And wow, look at that touch. Sit.
Oh my God.
I thought it was perfect.
Me too. It was absolutely epic touch, but it just slides.
That's crazy.
Slides off the back of the green. I mean,
dang, I thought I was going to check up for sure.
How much room is there? Like 12 feet?
Maybe a 15? Little bit more. Yeah.
It's 15. Very close. And those wood chips, man, they are slidey.
Okay.
Missy has a jump putt.
Does she?
Yeah.
A jump putt approach.
Yes. Jump putt to the green.
Okay. Like, is this one that you're dialing up?
I'd be thinking about it.
You would.
Kristen, tester.
Yeah. This is to hang on to her lead, at least over her card mate, Paige Pierce. Ooh. All right. Soft run.
Yeah.
Stays in bounds.
Really nice. She didn't put a lot of spin on it, so it grabbed as soon as it missed.
Juliana with the best look for birdie here, but just lays it up. We're going to see some birdies on this one.
Yes, we
this
will.
This was atypical. Usually you see one or two people on the card maybe struggle a little bit, but I think a lot of people don't love this hole because of all the OB, but I actually really like it.
Yeah, it feels a little poke and hopey, but once you play it a few times, there is a route.
There is a route.
Mm-hmm. 29% of the field taking a birdie. That many getting to circle one in regulation, almost 50 getting to circle two in regulation. So our feature card just not showing us the routes.
And Paige really just summarizing that hole for us.
And that's going to put Emily into a tie for the lead. Kristen dropping back one spot. Hole 17, a new hole for us, 305 feet. Downhill off the tee pad, but this hole plays a little bit uphill, I would say.
Yeah, it does.
The basket is a little shorter than what we saw last year. Definitely more scoreable, but no easier by any means as far as the line goes. It's still a very tight gap, and if you miss right, you can very easily find yourself into some pretty sticky situations. Safe play is just bailing out something overstable left and then scrambling your par.
Yep, like what Juliana's doing, although she actually might have a putt. Also, I learned the hard way, if you pull it to the right side and then kick backwards OB, you can take it from where it went out, or there's a drop zone down there.
Oh, my God.
Yep. Oh.
I didn't realize there was out of bounds that was in play
on
the left side.
Yeah, you're teeing off over OB, basically.
So if you just catch an early tree.
Yep. Oof. Missy, inside the circle, really great shot. She threw an ESP Thrasher.
Paige doing the crash play to the left, and she gets pin high. She'll have a putt, I think, inside the circle.
Yeah, Z buzz from Paige. And just has that one tree to beat. Kristen going to drop short, but in bounds? Give her the green.
Wow.
Give her the green flag. She's fine. Yep. She's close, though.
Mm-hmm. 40%?
It comes into play, like, surprisingly more than you'd think.
Yeah, that's not something I was even considering.
Me neither.
40% of the field got a birdie on this one. That's
more
that's
than awesome.
I was expecting.
I think this is also a fantastic change from last year. Also, it took me like two rounds to figure out that I think it is slightly uphill.
Yeah.
Because it looks like you're throwing downhill.
It looks like you want to throw a putter or a mid, but then
you don't.
You can't get there.
Yeah. It's really an interesting and beautiful shot, honestly.
Paige a little further from the basket than I thought.
Let's get that third slow-mez going.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty wide straddle from Paige here. Just
a little left.
Yep. Missy missing right side. Oh, man. I know. Similar distance on the comebacker.
Hey, nice comeback putt from Missy to save her par. Oof.
Oh, yeah.
Paige has some work left.
Good save.
Okay.
A little left side ringer. Nothing but smiles from Paige and Missy. They're good saves.
Mm-hmm. 75% of the field got to circle two in regulation, but only 40 getting to circle one. So it is easy to get up there and get up the fairway. It's just how hard do you want to push to get to this green?
Mm-hmm.
I like this change a lot.
Me too. One, two, go. Emily Beach now in the solo lead, 8 down through 17. Kristen Tatar solo second. And this is one heck of a hole to finish on.
The round ruiner.
Yeah. 905 feet, par 5. Uphill tee shot. You just want to throw as far as you can, obviously. And then I think it's good to stay to the right side of the fairway on the second shot. And then the third shot is very demanding if you want to try to attack for birdie. You can see how narrow the OB comes on the left. The right side is inbounds, but very rough if you end up in the trees. And also, it's so exposed. You're so hot. It's sunny. Yep, you feel downtrodden when you get here. You're like, oh, man.
Yeah, you
so
can't,
far left.
Yeah, on 17, you're not like one more hole. You're like, I have hole 18.
I have 18.
Yeah.
Yeah. It is.
It played as the most difficult hole statistically. As well, averaging at almost 3/4 of a stroke over par.
Unlike most of the holes on the course, this one stacks up strokes if you make a mistake. If you go OB, it's very hard to save even a bogey.
Yeah, 9 times out of 10, if you do go out of bounds, you're most likely going to be taking it from far back, because if you go out of bounds, you're probably trying to cross it for a large area.
You must be a Canada goose. I just decided that.
This is a pretty normal play, throwing something into this group of trees and landing and just kind of dealing.
Look at how long.
Oh, my God. Okay.
I'm going to chalk that up to heat.
That is how we all felt all day.
Yeah.
It looks like a beautiful, sunshiny day.
It's awful.
It's absolutely.
Everyone hates it now.
We don't want to be like complaining, but it was miserable.
Yeah. Like props to the people who showed up to watch this, because I would never.
No, if you don't have to be outside today, you should not. And I'm just so glad that they caught Paige doing that, because
how many times did you do that exact motion today?
And everyone on this coverage so far looks so like pristine. Yeah. And like it's not a big deal.
Like, you don't
we're
see
happy.
People wiping the sweat with their shirts. And okay, back to like what's happening.
I want a slow mess of Paige.
Juliana, like I said, working that right side. She does clip some trees. The ideal play, this big bushy tree in the middle that this spotter is crouching next to, if you can be past it on the left or right, but typically you see people go right around it, you can think about attacking, though it is pretty treacherous.
Again, like Erica said in the flyover, it's still a very demanding shot, but doable, especially if you have an easy 360 feet of distance uphill.
Well, yeah, I was going to say, so I landed to the right of the bush. It was like one of my better shots to get there too. And it was still 385 uphill to the pin.
Carrying OB.
Or at least challenging it.
Yep.
Missy looks like she gets caught up in the tree. Everyone a little shorter than you want to be. Paige, likely a layup. You just kind of want to lay up to where it starts to narrow, I think. There's like one large tree that Paige is next to that you can't quite see on screen, but that's perfect. Mm-hmm. And then it narrows and then it widens again at the green.
Yeah, that's a super ideal landing spot.
Juliana likely going to throw the hyzer, similar to Paige as well. Blind hyzer, it's scary. There's OB there. Great shot. I wonder if Juliana ever thought, like, oh, man, 24 years from now, I'm going to be playing this as a professional disc golfer
on,
still.
With, you know, 5 cameras around me with a feature.
Yep. No. You don't think she thought about it? So great to see her out here, especially she tied for third at Portland. Like, she's just killing it.
Mm-hmm. Kristen throwing her third shot now.
Ooh. I was going to say, that's going to be scary if she carries over the OB all the way, but she kind of turfs it. She's not in a bad spot, though, to get par still.
No.
Not great, but not bad.
You can see that uncharacteristic miss there. That is wholly due to how hot it is. I mean, I'm telling you, everyone is so mentally fatigued right now. It is unbelievable. I wish you could, like, see a little battery above their head.
It would be blinking red.
For sure. But what a great recovery from Kristen.
Now it's saying your phone is too hot. Please cool down.
Yeah. Our phones all day were blinking. Do no outdoor activities allowed. Stay inside at all cost. And we're just out here for 4 hours. Throwing really excellent disc golf shots with your Paige Pierce.
Yeah, and that's a good scramble. Paige kind of hit that early tree, but she's up there for par. Juliana looking like she's trying to draw medal from hole one all the way through hole 18. Solid round.
I'm going to see a little more pinched here, but still a line.
It's not easy. Mm-hmm. Like, that is a really fantastic shot. It is pinched, and, like, she was basically throwing straight at the OB line and with that, a pretty extreme angle.
And that right side tree line is might as well be its own form of OB. It is so thick. Paige with a great finish, holding strong all the way through hole 18. Missy with a great par as well. There was only three birdies on the day. Kat Murch, Maria Oliva, and Jennifer Allen getting fours.
Kristen finishing with a par. Seven down on the day.
And a par frame on 18. Ain't bad.
That's dang good.
Yep, Juliana, hometown hero. Look at that gallery in full force.
And here we go. Kristen tied for first with Emily Beach at seven down. Paige Pierce solo third, six down. And Macy Velladillas going to join us on the feature guard at five down. Holland Hanley tying her, going to be top of chase tomorrow.
Nice to see Valerie Mantujano up at the top of the lead card. Maria Oliva, Missy Gannon, Kat Murch, Leah Sinigeni, and Allie Smith all tied in that four down position. And that's what you have to be in the top 10 now. You got to have birdies out there. Looks like the top 20 is either even as at even par or better. And we still have two more rounds. Again, we have storms in the forecast tomorrow. We have a nice sunny day on Sunday. So we'll see what happens. Hopefully we will be hanging out with you guys tomorrow. We're at Pickard Park. I'm Madison Walker.
I'm Erica Stinchcomb. We're the two hot geese, y'all.
Honk.